hundreds of them, she says, needs more money and more manpower to prosecute.
So you want to know what I need? You want me to be specific? For that historical backlog, I want 2.7 million. That translates into 23 employees that will focus on those cases.
D.A. Willis believes the state's largest county has a gang problem and describes the spike in violent crime as unacceptable. At least one commissioner agrees Willis needs more resources to fight back.
Give her the money. She's having to make a presentation. She's having to pretty much beg. And I take issue if we are talking about crime and making sure that we're going after crime, the money needs to be there. She needs to be able to do what she needs to do.
D.A. Willis urging county commissioners to act, assuring them violent crime will be on the top of mind for voters this fall.
And the number one issue for the mayor's race and for each of your races is going to be crime. You want to know why? Because you can't even go to the gas station in our county anymore.
As you can see of the situation here, we're told that we don't know many details at this point, but people who live and work in this area were on the scene trying to figure out what happened, and as we know more, we will, of course, bring you that information. A surge in gun violence like the stories we just told you about have local leaders and police scrambling to come up with ways to stop it. It was the topic of a town hall meeting held in Midtown, Atlanta tonight, and Fox 5 anchor Courtney Bryant has details.
Public safety is a responsibility that goes beyond policing.
Atlanta Police Chief Rodney Bryant says he wholeheartedly supports community patrols. It's something the Midtown Neighborhood Association does. The MNA is split into two districts, each with their own patrol. The chief says in order to help police, residents need to know what's happening.
Gangs have their hand in almost every aspect of crime inside the city.
Chief Bryant acknowledges a serious gang problem in the city, but says it's not the number one reason behind the surge in gun violence.
It is not gang violence, it is not domestic violence, it is not drugs. It is two people who fail to have a level of conflict resolution.
During a town hall hosted by the MNA, Chief Bryant joined other leaders to address all aspects of crime. That includes illegal street racing, and Chief Bryant says they're seeing success.
It has, as you stated, we've not eradicated it, but it has come down.
He credits a strategy focused on stopping street racers before they come into the city. These are the stats from the most recent operation with Georgia State Troopers. Another concern, young men selling bottled water at intersections. While the city is offering other safer opportunities to make money, APD Major Prinzetta Span says some drivers are actually making the problem worse.
These young people are making at least $500 a day. Anything the city has to offer, you can only imagine that it would be difficult because we can't compete with $500 a day.
Another concern, repeat offenders.
That is a real bad problem. It's disheartening to the men, it's disheartening to the community because you may see a person get arrested and now they're back out there the next day. But it's also disheartening to a police officer who's worked hard to get a person off the street.
Chief Bryant says there is no system in place for courts, the jail, APD, and other law enforcement entities to conduct an adequate background check on a person.
When a judge sees an individual and doesn't hold them to what they deem to be a repeat offender, it's because the judge don't have all the information.
Courtney Bryant.
A surge in gun violence like the what we were just reporting about. New and tonight, investigators are trying to figure out what sparked a fire at a DeKalb County hair salon.
Burned in the back of his neck and his arm. He says this was an intense team effort that quickly shifted from detaining someone to saving a life. Suspected car thief trapped inside this burning vehicle on Turner Lake Road in Newton County.
It's just hey, this, we gotta get this guy out. He's gonna burn alive, so we gotta get him out.
You can hear the driver's cry for help.
At the top, I got the bottom. Keep going.
As officers rushed to get him out of the vehicle and contain the flames. According to Georgia State Patrol, they were able to get him halfway out of the burning car, but his feet were still trapped after he crashed into a tree.
When the driver's side doors opened, I was in the floorboard. I was trying to get his foot out.
The flames quickly got bigger, and then there was an explosion.
It came back towards us. I jumped out of the car. He was laying down prone, so he missed a lot of it because it kind of caught most of me in the face, like right up here, and it burnt most of my hair off.
Covington police tell us this all began on June 28th when officers spotted Billy Campbell, who was from North Carolina, driving a stolen security vehicle.
Received life-saving awards from Cobb Fire Rescue and a lifetime of thanks from Phillips.
Thank them profusely for saving my life, and grateful that we had this Poseidon alarm available to alert people that I was in trouble.
Phillips underwent double bypass surgery and is in cardiac rehab now. He's eager to get back in the pool.
I'm looking forward to coming back to swim. I'm feeling great, and great to be alive.
Every YMCA in Metro Atlanta has the same system at their pools. In Cobb County. A part of the memory care program.
My mom's been here 2.5 years, and tonight will be her last.
Byers, along with other family members, are now scrambling to find their loved ones a new place to stay.
Janice and Brian Stewart, they're the managers with it, who own this property, have failed us in a big way.
Not only are residents and their families unsure of their futures, so are the staff members, like Executive Director Tiffany Eccles.
It's so inhumane. How do you do elderly people that way? How do you do your staff that way?
She says she's now trying to figure out how to say goodbye to a place filled with people she's called family for the last 2.5 years.
I have my staff here that will stick it out with me until Friday. We're not sure if we will be paid, but we're going to stick it out for the love of our residents.
I did reach out to the owners of this place, but did not get a call back from them. Now, staff from nearby assisted living facilities have been so generous. They've been stopping by, helping the residents as well as staff out with food, care, as well as helping find the residents a place to stay. In Acworth, Janice Yu, Fox 5 News.
When is Lime going to remove their scooters? Bob Slim in North Island. Come and get these scooters of yours, Lime. They do not belong there, period. If they stay here any longer, they're going to go into a dumpster, Lime. Do you understand? Get them off of this walkway and don't put them here again. Down here where the Plaza Theater is, Urban Outfitters, FedEx, Buffalo Exchange, Majestic Diner. Come and get your junk. Hey, Georgia Power, I don't know what happened. Had one of these scenes come down. One of them on the corner. So, there you go, Highland at North Highland. Yep, it's gone up about $1 in the past. Yeah, it's gone up at least $1. I'm glad this is fixed. You should not be able to use that sidewalk. Broken ankle much? I don't know what this is in here. Automated cover, I don't know. Looks like it might be. Yep. Got caught in a Dagburn rain. That thing belongs in a museum. Anybody old enough to remember using one of them? Don't like the weather of late 15. That is. Let the music take your mind. Just release and you will find. Oh, he crashed in. When they get tired of being kicked, they do something. Got the place all to myself today. Ain't nobody else around. Nobody's here today. Where are they all at? At work? At a protest? Who knows? I hope pickup's pretty soon. I'm down here in a little 5. It's a Zesto, well, or it was a Zesto. If people ride these things so much, why has this thing been sitting on private property of the public on Ponce de Leon for over 3 weeks? It's not making anybody any money. Don't you think someone should come and get it? 1001. Ponce de Leon Avenue, Northeast Atlanta. Get rid of this junk. It's on private property. And it's caught up with me. Say bye.
Ciao.
It's all about the kick. You don't have to do it hard. You just gotta do it often. When you get tired being kicked, they will do something.